staff performance when it to respond to the part about how do you know if there's an area that they need to strengthen or there's a deficit in the staff's performance? I think you was one of the things you said. You can kind of look at it like an ABC model. So antecedent behavior consequence. So you can look at staff performance in a way that takes personality out of it and takes blame out of it. And you can say, okay, from an antecedent perspective, does a staff member, here's a staff member's performance. The antecedents may be, do they have the training, their original repertoire, the physical ability, the materials, all these things that go into make, do they have the correct instructions and objectives and the right direction? And here's the performance. And then from a consequence end, you can look at it as though, are they getting reinforcement out of their performance? Or are they getting negative reinforcement or positive reinforcement or punishment? So you can look at it as a three-term contingency at times when you look at staff performance. You can pull out the personality issues like, oh, Sally just doesn't like me or things like that. You can just look at it from a three-term contingency and determine. Now, what I find is that you have to almost assume at first that things are antecedent issues. Don't necessarily think that someone's unmotivated or lazy or complacent. Look at all those antecedents first so that you're not blaming the employee. Look at the things in the beginning, like were their objectives very clear? Therefore, do they know all their KPIs like that they're being evaluated on? So we have the weekly scorecard that gets circulated or the survey tool. Do they have the ability to do, you know, if you're unfortunately in an emergency physical restraint, do they have the ability to do it? You can't just blame them if all of a sudden they, the learner got loose, but they also have, you know, a broken arm or something. I don't know, I'm just making up stuff, but it's an antecedent issue. You know, are all those things there? And then once you've ruled out training, objectives, clear directions, then you can look at the performance that's a problem and say, all right, they have all these things. Now is it that they're not motivated? Why is there a performance deficit? And then you can start determining whether you need to remediate things on a consequence end. Are they, you know, do you need to use different types of reinforcement for that staff? Do you need to use, unfortunately, some people have a history of behaving and performing under negative reinforcement. And it's what I really prefer the least, to see people motivated out of fear or out of undesirable things. I'd rather see people, obviously, as Aubrey Daniels calls it, discretionary effort. I'd rather see people motivated based on, you know, shooting for something bigger, bigger vision, intermittent reinforcement, then they engage in creative behavior to go for it, as opposed to avoiding being fired.